It's time to wake the dead.
Cushing, Christopher Lee, both starring in I, Monster. Your host, Professor MC Square. Musical director, Pointy, with Snippy the Dead Clown. Featuring Fritz, Leah the Mummy, and occasionally Helga on...
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a splendid movie for you tonight. Are you ready for a good movie?
Yeah.
You are?
Hey.
Yeah.
Did you call Fritz? Okay, Fritz is off tonight. Take an F. But this movie has Christopher Lee, Peter Cushing. It is...
I like them both.
It's a Jekyll and Hyde tale. It's called I, Monster. And it's filmed... sort of in a 3D effect. And what they do, they exploit something called the Fulfridge effect, and that is...
I want to say that a little bit more Teutonically.
Pulfrick.
Roll the R.
Pulfrick.
There you go.
Pulfrick effect!
Yes!
Is what they're using to make a 3D movie that doesn't really work unless you have the glasses. But here's the good news. You don't have to have real 3D glasses. You could just take a pair of sunglasses, pop out the left lens, and you'll see that this movie has, even without the glasses, it has this weird effect, a weird kind of a vibe going on. But that's how you do it. Just take some sunglasses and remove the left lens.
Boss, yes. I conveniently have sunglasses on in this scene, but... How do I get the left lens out?
I don't know. Look at that. Ready to go.
Roll the crap.
Roll the movie. I, Monster. Roll it.
Here is a briefcase for you, boss.
Oh, a briefcase. Thank you. Very nice.
Is that good?
Yes, it was great. That's good.
Dang.
Okay, so we're watching I, Monster tonight. Christopher Lee, Peter Cushing, and it is...
And Faith Hill.
A red herring. I can see you. This is a stagehand doing like some puppetry all in black, except for that big Zappa head of yours.
Whoa, a robot!
Robot!
And he's writing something.
Low rent robot.
I was sent from the future. Sent from the future? Who sent you? I did. I made you in the future. That's crazy, isn't it?
You made a hobo bot.
The best I could do was like cardboard and a human neck.
I think this is the wing.
Why are you writing with a pencil? Okay, all right. All right. So anyway, why did I send you? What's the deal? To capture the MacGuffin. A MacGuffin. Pointy, are you back there somewhere?
What?
Pointy, what's a MacGuffin?
I think it's kind of like a pubic toupee.
No, that's American.
Oh, it's like an English muffin with egg and sausage.
No, MacGuffin.
Oh, McMuffin.
It's like a plot device. It's like like the Holy Grail. It's like something that everyone is trying to get to, and the thing that they're all struggling. Like the thing in Pulp Fiction in the suitcase. That's
The hamburgers, the Royales.
Oh. Huh. Wonder if. Anything in here in this briefcase that Stiffy brought in? Could it be?
Oh.
Look at that. I blew it.
Your favorite show is F Troop.
Let's get back to iRobot.
Honey, I'm bored. Let's play a game.
Do we have to?
Yes.
What do you want to play?
Truth or dare?
Okay. Who goes first?
Well, you could go first. Okay. What do you want, truth or dare?
Truth.
Build me a submarine. That's not how
true.
I know I did it wrong. I'm stupid. All right, truth or dare?
No.
You had something to do with the Hindenburg exploding.
True.
You're a scamp, Ernie.
Yeah, well, you know, one of those situations where I know it was selfish, but sometimes I can't turn down a good cigar.
Okay, who gives a my turn.
What do you want, truth or dare?
Well, you know me, Ernie.
Bag.
You know me. Dare.
Okay, I'm gonna put an end to this right now. Go get naked!
You think I won't do it?
I know you won't do it.
You think you're gonna win?
Of course! That's always been a deal breaker in the past!
Well, watch this! House coat off?
I want to thank our fans because once again, second year in a row, we got an award. We got a Rondo Award. That's right, for our zombie events. The first year was for the zombie walk at the mall. This year for World Zombie Day. And what a wonderful honor. This year we went, like last year, to Louisville, to the convention called Wonderfest, to accept the award. Do we have footage of that? Can we roll that?
Shut up!
For everyone who voted for us, because this was voted for by fans, not like a judged thing or anything like that, thank you very much. two rondos now for the It's Alive show. Thank you very much. I'm really enjoying this movie tonight. It's interesting, and for a change, it's not dubbed. We enjoy the Spanish, the Italian horror movies, but it's nice tonight to have a movie that's in English, and actually an English film. You know,
English?
It is. It's an English film.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Yes.
I am a lad.
You're a lad.
I'm a lad.
You're a mummy.
Do you want to see my jig?
Yes, I'd love to see a jig.
My lad jig.
Okay. Hit it. Tonight is a midnight snack. I'm going to make something. This was a recipe given to me by a friend, a very nice man who recently passed away. His name was Joe, and he went to all of our zombie walks. He was the Titanic zombie. Great fan of the show, and this is one of his recipes. And it's tuna salad with tomatoes or something like that, but I call it tuna stink. So let's have actually Joe's son come in here to help me with this. The drunk knight. Joe, very proud right now, I'm sure.
Thank you.
So anyway, this was your dad's recipe.
Yes.
And you've made this quite a few times, and I enjoy it. Everybody in the cast likes it with the tuna stink.
It's very healthy.
It, part of it's the name, too. You know, just tuna stink. You just want to have some. You just want to try it to see how stinky it is. And it's got a smell to it, you know.
Depending on how you make it, it could be very stinky.
So let's get down to it. How do we get started here?
Chop up that onion.
Okay. An onion? One onion.
One whole onion. This is a Vidalia onion, by the way, like a sweeter onion. You don't want to get something that's too...
stinky?
Too stinky. Usually the ratio is one full onion, two tomatoes. If you only have one tomato, then go with a half onion.
This is a big enough bowl.
Yeah, well...
You think it is?
Sure,
I got a bigger bowl.
Yeah, that's good enough for now.
We could switch it.
Okay.
Let's switch it.
Okay, so everything into the bowl, and then one large can of tuna. Wow, no, that would be Herod.
Okay.
Drain it a little bit, and then just right in there.
Okay. Tuna is drained.
Beautiful. Right in there. Just grab a fork and then...
All the cats in the neighborhood. I can hear them outside.
So then you want to put a little bit of olive oil on top of there.
Okay. A little olive oil? About how much? Just a drizzle.
There you go. That's about
like that? Okay.
Just to keep things from sticking together while you're mixing it around.
All right. And what else we have? Red wine vinegar?
Red wine vinegar.
And you just tell me
to
when.
To taste.
Okay. I'll just start splashing.
That's good. You can always add more later if you need it to be stronger and stickier.
Okay. All right.
And the balsamic.
Balsamic.
Vinegar.
How much of that?
A little more of that.
A little more
That's
of that?
For the color and the flavor.
Okay.
There you go. That should be good. Try that. Mix it around.
Okay. Is that it, or?
That's pretty much it. You can do whatever you want to taste.
You know what I like a little bit more.
I like, actually.
One second. Hello? Mr. Neighbor. What's the matter? It smells, I know. Yes, the neighborhood cats are making a lot of noise. I'm making something out of tuna. I don't care. Listen, buddy. Now, don't give me any... He's shooting at us!
It's okay, everyone calm down. I'm a superhero.
Look out!
I can handle this. Nice. I got him. One shot.
Boss, there's people outside!
Thank you.
special treat for you this week. Have one of the ultimate Monsters collections owned by Tony Greco, my good friend, and he's going to show us around some of the Monsters stuff that he has. When did you start with this, Tony?
Oh, well, I originally collected during the show back in 64 and 65, but then it waned a little, and then my interest come back probably in the 80s. And with the advent of the internet, it's made it so much easier, but before that, it was really tough to find toys. Nobody wanted to kick with their stuff.
It got a little too easy with eBay.
Oh, easy. It's a double-edged sword.
So show us around some of the things that you've collected over the years.
Yes.
Now, are these Fred Gwynn's foreheads you have here?
This is Fred's from the Munster's Revenge. This is Sam McMurray's from the Munster Scary Little Christmas back in 96. This was John Shucks from the Munsters Today, 1981. This is Eddie's from Here Come the Munsters in 95. Same with Grandpa's from 1995, Here Come the Munsters. This is one that Don Post had put out in the early 70s, a Herman Munster forehead. Now, these are originals from the 60s. This is a Herman Munster.
Is that made out of human skin? I think I had this one.
The Munster coach in the box. It came with the paint. Here it is.
Looks like you got more than triples going on there.
Over here.
Now, speaking of duplicates, we're starting to get a little crazy here with the Herman. What are these, puppets or
these
dolls?
These are talking dolls and talking hand puppets.
I'm Herman Munster. How do you do?
This was probably the hottest machine back in 2001 to 2003. Everywhere you would go, you would see tons and tons of Munster slots.
Is this Lily's costume?
This is a Lily costume that Lee Merriweather wore in the Munsters Today.
Now, you also have something really crazy. It's not in this room, but we could put a picture up. The Dragula. You think we could do a segment where I could take it out for a spin in the future?
Of course.
Might be a little hard to get it back, though. Might be a little hard to get the keys back, though. You know, when you say, give me those keys back, you know what I'm going to say?
I don't want them.
We're watching commercials right now. You know what that means? Good time. Go to the fridge. Grab yourself an ice-cold straw beer. Oh, it's an all-natural beer. No sugar, no salt. No preservatives. Straw beer. What do you like about it, buddy?
I like that it won't come back from the future to kill you.
Straw beer. It won't come back from the future to kill you. It's natural.
And that wraps up I, Monster. Like the transformation at the end. Much better than the Wolfman. There was a DVD extra with this. Let's take a look at the full transformation. We had a lot of crazy things happen tonight. We had a MacGuffin in a briefcase, lost it. There was a red herring. And we learned that the robot that was...
Robot.
Apparently sent by me back from the future. His name is Deus Ex Machina, and he himself is actually a time machine. So, you know what, let's try this time machine thing. I don't want it to be the end of the show. Let's go back to the beginning. Ready? Stagehand with your big Zappa head. Holy crap, a Terminator! I shouldn't have done that. That wasn't good. Let's go back. Let's go back 10 seconds. Holy crap, a Terminator! Holy crap, a Terminator! A Terminator! A Terminator!